the West, the self-proclaimed paragon of free speech and free press, has been on a censorship spree as of late. Actually, this is something that has been building up for years, and now it is in full motion. We've seen US-based social media networks censoring everybody, pulling down, you know, accounts of national leaders and erasing, you know, international news organizations from their platforms simply because they run contra to US and Western European special interests. And now we see in the UK, Ofcom, the Office of Communications, they have revoked the license of China Global Television Network. CGTN is the Chinese state media, and they do international news, like Russia's RT, kind of. And it says here in this article by Bloomberg, UK ends Chinese TV license, stoking tensions with Beijing. The UK's media regulator has pulled Chinese state-run television channel CGTN off the air, a decision that is set to deepen tensions with Beijing. And they're saying that the new owner would be disqualified from holding a license as it would be controlled by a body ultimately directed by the Chinese Communist Party, Ofcom said. And of course, by that logic, the BBC shouldn't be allowed to operate anywhere outside UK borders because it is British state media. It's on its own website. They say that their goal is to advance British, you know, values around the globe, and they claim those values are fairness and objectivity, etc. But we all know that that's not true. We could just look at their coverage of the lead up to the US-UK invasion of Iraq in 2003, or their coverage of Libya and Syria in 2011, their coverage of the US-engineered coup in Ukraine in 2013 to 2014, and their coverage of Hong Kong, which is funny because they mention Hong Kong. They mention Hong Kong here. Well, they say right here, Ofcom is required by law to prevent bodies whose goals are mainly political from becoming or remaining TV license holders. Last year, Ofcom found CGTN breached impartiality rules in its coverage of Hong Kong protests. Didn't the BBC do exactly that? Wasn't their reporting one-sided and leaning heavily toward British interests, which along with the US is to reassert Western control and influence over Hong Kong at the expense of Chinese sovereignty. They never talked about the US government funding those protests, which is now a confirmed, verified fact. They downplayed the violence and the way they framed the whole one country, two systems agreement that Beijing made during the 1997 handover. They never talk about the racist, imperialist history of why the British were in Hong Kong in the first place. They took it by force. And when Beijing agreed to that back in 1997, China was nowhere near as strong as it is today. They basically agreed to it under duress simply to get their territory back. And now that they have it back and they're powerful enough, they're asserting their control over their own territory, which should never have been taken in the first place. And you never see that reflected in any of the BBC's coverage. They just act like, well, Beijing agreed to it, and they need to hold to it, no matter how unfair that agreement was, and no matter how unfair and criminal the British Empire's behavior was towards China for decades and decades. So this is going to boomerang back to the West. The West is doing this whole censorship spree right now in the first place because alternative media around the world, independent alternative media, and state-sponsored alternative media around the globe is growing, and it is challenging the West's monopoly over global information space. And the West also still intrudes into any given nation's information space. The Western media has a huge presence everywhere, in every country. And in some countries, like here in Thailand, they still dominate the narratives. The political crisis here in Thailand, the US-backed anti-government protests here in Thailand, they are such a problem because the media promotes them on a daily basis, endlessly. And there's no counterbalance to that coverage. In terms of English language media countering the narratives of the Western media here in Thailand, you don't have any of that. But Thailand can look at Ofcom in the UK. They can look at the criteria that they used to allow or disallow a foreign media organization to operate within the UK's borders, and they could apply that to here in Thailand, and they could take the whole FCCT and basically deport all of them out of the country. They could revoke all of their visas and just send them home. Countries like Thailand can fight back by using their own standards against them to uproot their political interference in here that operates under the guise of journalism. So I just thought I would point that out. You know, I'm gonna put this link in here. There's also what the BBC's own website says about what its mission is. I'm also gonna put this one in from The Guardian. Study deals blow to claims of anti-war bias in the BBC, and they talk about how the BBC was the most pro-war in the lead up to the 2003 US-UK invasion of Iraq. So I'm gonna put those links in there. There's also gonna be links in there about how you can help support my work, like by becoming a Patreon member or, you know, a one-time donation. But if you're not able to do that, and all you do is like and share my videos or subscribe to my channel or just send kind words to me, that is also greatly appreciated. I honestly could not do this work without all of that support. So thank you everybody for helping and supporting my work. And as always, thank you for watching.